Hi, and welcome to this tutorial. I will show you how to transcribe and how to use this Google speech-to-text to become audio or MP3 files to text. It will be very useful for you, and of course, it's free, and the setup is very, very easy and fast. To actually do this, we need a driver, additional driver for our sound card. To do this, just go to your Google and type virtual cable. Virtual cable, okay, and you will got this result in a first page, right? You can go to the virtual audio virtual apps, VB audio software, and over here we got our virtual cable. Just scroll down all down over here to download this cable and click this big orange download button, and it will download us, for example, to your desktop. Click save, minimize your Chrome, just click if you open it, you will get a lot of these files, so don't just don't 7-zip and go to extract here, because you will swarm the desktop. Instead, use this, and it will create the subfolder for our virtual cable. So just go inside this virtual cable and choose the installation that that you want. You will get this this window, and just click install driver. Ah, okay. If you you need to add administrator, and just right click it and run it in the as an administrator. Click yes, and click again install driver. And this is it. You might reboot your system to finalize installation. Come back after you reboot your computer. Hi, and welcome back. If you rebooted your computer, now it's a perfect time to continue. You can go to you can see your changes by going down there and in this clicking right click on these speakers and click playback devices. If you click this, you will get this all your devices, and this one will be our cable, virtual cable, this one, and in recording devices also we got our cable driver. What I'm going to do now is that I prepared one MP3 file and one video file, so you can see how this works when I enable these drivers. I will not be able to comment on the transcription process, because it will turn off my microphone and I won't be able to hear anything, because it will also turn off my speakers. So to do this, you can just go to your Google Drive, and in your Google Drive, just click new, a new Google Docs. If I go again in my sound, I will now enable all of that and play MP3 file and play this video file. You won't hear me, so just watch it. Hi, and welcome. If you got this error in your Audacity, it means that you are missing a library. So to do this, it's a very simple process. Just click OK and go again on File, Export Audio, choose MP3 files in this drop down, click Save. You got this Edit Metadata window. Hi, and welcome. If you got this error in your Audacity, it means that you are missing a library. So to do this, it's a very simple process. Just click OK and go again on File, Export Audio, choose MP3 files in this drop down, click Save. Okay, I'm back, and you will. You can see that we just write the text, which was a talk on a audio file. And one tip is that don't leave this screen. And first, you want to click play your video file or your audio file, and then click record Davis. One thing only I want to show you, so you don't need to every time click on this thing and click on a playback Davis's and recording Davis's and so on, is to just go and find, for example, audio switcher, and go to audio switcher home. After you go here and you just click this is a free program, and click download. Go on a desktop and click save. Click save, and in a zip file, you can see this audio switcher, just put it on a desktop, close the zip file. You can also delete those files, you don't need it anymore. And if you click audio switcher, you got this audio switcher, you got this pane, and you also have this cable input, and in the recording pane you get this cable output driver. You can adjust the hotkey and set up hotkey, for example this one, click save. I'm sorry, this is in a use. If I this hotkey and click save, and you have a hotkey when you need to switch between the devices. If you just need this, play a bit and you will find out your perfect solution. For me, this is very, very useful stuff, because we are using the Google Translator database of the voice to type it, and it will. It is not perfect, of course. The robots are still not perfect, but it will help us tremendously to make these things, this transcription, easier. I use this for my tutorials to make closed captions and to make transcriptions and so on. This is it for me, guys. Thanks for watching, and bye-bye.